Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Larnaca 2015 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Larnaca Olympic Shooting Range. The finals competition for the trap women's event will now begin. There are two Olympic quota places up for grabs in today's finals. If the highest scoring countries of this event have already received their maximum amount of quota places, those places would automatically go to the highest scoring countries below. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you the finalists. At position number one, representing Finland, Olympic Games gold medalist in Beijing in 2008 and three times World Cup gold medalist, Satu Makela-Nummela.
Yes, an Olympic gold medalist, as you said, in Beijing. The 44-year-old took fifth in our lane and will want a medal here.
At position number two, representing Australia, making her first appearance in the final six of a World Cup, Emma Cox.
In an experienced field, the 22-year-old will be looking to show what she can do with a first World Cup medal.
At position number three, representing the United States of America, Olympic Games bronze medalist in Beijing and two times World Cup gold medalist, Corey Cogdell.
Yes, the world number eight didn't need a shoot-off to get to the semi-final and she'll be hoping for a smooth passage in the medal matches.
At position number four, representing the Russian Federation, World Cup silver medalist in Almaty last year and World Cup bronze medalist, Tatiana Barsuk.
Yes, a World Cup silver in Almaty last year. She'll be aiming for a first gold here in Larnaca.
At position number five, representing Slovakia, two times Olympic Games silver medalist and five times World Cup gold medalist, Zuzana Rehak-Sevichikova.
Yes, 31 years of age now, hugely experienced, including, of course, those two Olympic medals.
And at position number six, representing Spain, World Cup gold medalist in London 2012 and two times World Cup silver medalist, Fatima Galvez.
Yes, top qualification, and she'll be in the hunt for a sixth World Cup medal.
The jury member in charge of this finals is Sotiris Sotiriou from Cyprus. And the referee for this finals is Ioannis Eraklios, also from Cyprus.
So there's the start list.
The very best of luck to
six
all our
athletes out of
Let's
the
begin
76
the women's
that
semi-final.
Started today. And so these are the six that have a chance to get a medal here in Larnaca. It is women's trap. And it'll be interesting to see, once we get underway, who can continue their form from the semi-finals.
Yes. Both Galvez and Stepakova both shot 73s, where Corey Cogdell had a 22. She had a 22 and then a 75, a 50 straight for a 72. Ready. Then Cox, Makela-Nummela, and Barsuk and Chang all have 71s. Good scores.
Good scores, yep, absolutely, especially in the blustery conditions.
And now we're back to zero.
Yeah, back to zero and away we go. And yeah, the conditions are a little bit blustery. You can see the wind turbines on the hills are turned around towards where the wind's coming from, over the shoulder of the shooters. And yeah, it's coming and going, a little bit blustery. Only three nations can get those Olympic quota places, Finland, Russia and Slovakia. Australia already have two. Corey Cogdell, of course, won in Acapulco. And Fatima Galvez won in the World Championships last year in Granada. So that's how it's standing. And we have our first miss of the competition, the Russian with the mistake.
Well, it's an excellent position for the three women who are in the finals, because no matter what happens, they're in really good shape. One of the two quota spots. Oh, Satu just missed one.
Yeah, she was a little bit up and down at the, in qualifying.
She had a 23-24-24. For those of you who are watching or listening, Corey just missed.
That's not over.
We're using table two, which has a lot of right and sharp 45-degree angles, which, given this wind, can be extremely challenging.
Absolutely.
As they dipsy and dirt turn. And
well, of course, they know that they're going to get, three at each station in the 15 in the semi-final. One left, yeah. One centre, one right, but you're not sure with the elevation, you're not sure a lot of things, are you? I mean, some things you know, but a lot of things you have to sort of hope.
You know you're getting a right, left and centre.
That's
from
about
each
it.
Post. And you also, because everyone shot this before, know what you're going to basically get. And, you know, you'll get, let's say if you're on post two, you get a 40 to the right and a 45 to the left.
Second miss for the American. It's not going well. The 28-year-old, married to an American footballer, the defensive end of the San Diego Chargers,
yes,
Mitch Unrein.
We thought he was going to come to Seattle, which would have been fun, but he's not. Okay,
Fetchikova is,
Susanna's doing well.
Yeah, she's just happily going along there.
Oh. Adam has found one.
Hey.
Early in the semi-final, one miss is not going to preclude you from the medal matches, but if you miss a couple, you really are on the back foot, and here is the American who just needs to keep hitting targets now.
Yeah, what happens at the beginning of the 15 and what happens at the end is sometimes very different, and people can miss at the beginning, keep hitting. I mean, Tatiana Barsik, the Russian, has missed the first one and going straight. Susanna is now the only one who is straight.
No target called by our referee, Ioannis Avaklios.
And looking at, I always like to tell with the guns, so Stefakova is shooting a Perazzi with Yoki ammunition.
It's such a personalized thing, isn't it? The balance of the gun.
Oh yeah, very much so.
Nature of the gun, the make of the gun. And you spend years trying to get that right, I guess.
You do. And sometimes you can just get it right. And sometimes you never get it right. But good coaches can help you. So Emma, in her first big competition, other than the Commonwealth Games, is shooting a Perazzi with RC4. Barsik is shooting a Beretta DT11 with Fiocchi Gold.
Stefanchikova, look at that, 5 out of 5. She's the one who's leading the field at the moment and will have the advantage.
And Fatima shoots a Perazzi with the Spanish shell.
So after those first 5 targets, as you can see, it's a perfect round there for Stefanchikova. Perfect start for her.
For the
that
Slovakian.
Puts her comfortably into first position
Stefan
with a total of 5 targets.
5 out of 5.
Currently there are
Barsuk,
4 athletes tied in second
Cox,
position. Makela-Nummela, Cox, Barsuk, and
Galvez
all tied in second position.
Very close.
With
in
a total of
4
position. Targets each.
And Corey Coggell has a little bit to make up there, but it's not beyond the bounds of possibility.
It isn't beyond it at all.
There's still obviously a long way to go in today's semi-final. 10 targets remain.
Good crowd here. Different crowd, of course. A lot coming up for the double trap, the skeet as well.
Yes.
Those shooters have made their way home.
Yes.
And now, just the 6 women left. Here's the Australian, Cox. Certainly in contention.
It's a beautiful background when you look out and when you're shooting it. Now, Corey shoots a Krieghoff, and she normally shoots Winchester, but here is shooting RC4 because the national team uses Winchester.
Also, just that miss on the first shot, and she's got into a good rhythm. Now the Slovakian still, well, that's the first miss. Yeah,
yep.
I'm going to say that just makes things a little bit more even.
40 degree angle to the left. Oh, and Fatima's just missed one on one.
It's certainly not a smooth semi-final. It's going to be who can crawl over the line first, really. Misses all over the place, but if you can keep your calm, collect your thoughts and keep going, that's when you'll get into the medal matches. Yeah.
There's a lot of different types of angle targets, and that's always challenging, especially when you go from having sharp 40, 45 degree angles to just little straight angles, and it makes a big difference.
Of course, in qualification, you have a couple of shots to get to play. here it's just the one. So you will see more misses.
And well, no, it's the same 25 targets, but this is 15 targets. So these women all, you know, have only missed one or two or three or four throughout 75 targets. So their lowest score any of them shot was at 23 out of 25.
They're just a single shot, of course, for the semifinals.
Yes. Yes,
which just
it
make
is.
It trickier.
Yes, it does. And it changes the psyche of it. It's a totally different psyche, shooting one shot.
Well, Makela-Nummela and Elizabeth
Corey
Cox at the moment, doing well. Here's Barsuk.
She's shooting well.
20th. And she has, after that hiccup at the beginning, certainly got her mind in the right place. And Stefa Chikova,
has
three in a row. Goodness me.
So I was
me.
Saying, it changes.
It certainly has changed, hasn't it?
Yes.
Galvez, topped qualification. Not topping the semi-final at the moment.
And Satu just missed that high one. And what happens too when somebody starts moving, sometimes it gets on a roll. You don't mean to pay attention, but you do hear it beeping. So sometimes you can get a little too cautious.
And the wind has picked up a little bit as this semi-final has continued.
Oh.
And there's another miss, a second one for Tatiana Barsuk. Oh. Stefa Chikova will be relieved more than anything to get white in the column.
Yes.
Now Galvez, again, would very much like to have that last five perfect.
She's a good shooter, solid.
It's a very experienced field, isn't it, bar Emma Cox?
Yes. Yes.
And here she is. And she's holding her end up well.
She is doing well. Emma started on the Australian team as a double trap shooter. And now is also shooting trap as well. So it's very good to do both. And Corey has certainly calmed down, or settled down.
Her world rank is 8, a world record holder, of course, as well.
Yes, and she shot brilliantly in Acapulco. She won the World Cup.
Very, very strong American presence there, of course, as well.
Yes.
Yes, that win in Acapulco. Her of a quota place.
So after that 10th target, as you can see, we have three
ten
new
targets,
leaders, Makela-Nummela, Cox
two thirds of the way
the
through, and it really has
moment,
changed
and
around. And Stefa Chikova down in
Cogdell,
equal
Stefa
fourth,
Chikova
but Barsuk, Cox, and Makela-Nummela, those are those
so one
athletes sitting pretty, just one
fourth,
ahead, of course, of Cogdell, Galvez,
after these next five targets, we will be deciding which two athletes are eliminated and also which athletes will be going into our medal matches. Five targets remain.
Just to remind you that if there are any ties, then there are shoot-offs, sudden death shoot-offs. At the moment, it will be a very tight affair.
So the top three, no, the bottom three are the top three ranked. So that's what happens when you shoot.
Well, that's the beauty for those of us watching, perhaps not for the shooters, of the new system where everyone starts equal in the semi-final, of course. Chance just to start over again, as long as you can get over the finishing line in qualification.
Yeah.
And Barsuk is looking okay here. Hits that target. In with a chance if she keeps going with the gold medal match. Stefa Chikova. Well, again, if she can regroup and start hitting the targets, who
Well, it
knows?
Looks like she has. Fatima definitely has to regroup.
Just Cogdell, who missed in that round.
There's Emma.
World ranked 32nd in the world. Scott Gold in the Oceania Championships. That's better from the American. She has a high world ranking of 8, but sometimes it means nothing.
Tatiana Barsuk has a world ranking of 20. And there's world rank number 1.
Yeah, she doesn't look too happy at all, does she?
No. And Galvez is ranked number 3 in the world. this setting is a tough setting, as I said, with the sharp angles. And you have to go from one sharp angle to another sharp angle, and when the wind's blowing, it causes them to drop and to fly.
Yep, at the moment the wind has just dropped a little bit, which again brings its own challenges of readjusting. Cogdill hits that one. It's very tight at the moment. It's the Finn who is ahead. As we head, just two more rounds after this one. Stefanchikova nails that one. And Emma Cox, the youngster amongst this lot, is looking pretty good at the moment.
She is.
For a shot at the gold medal match, if nothing else.
Hey.
Shot that round pretty well. On to the penultimate round of shooting.
So it looks like Satu is now, will be in one of the medal matches.
Well, she has a point of vantage and she'd expect to nail the last one, but never take anything
never
for granted,
expect.
I guess.
Not in the final.
And another miss. It's one. Not really been the final she would have hoping for Corey Cogdell.
No, it really hasn't been. And it's certainly not like the final in Acapulco.
No. And she took the gold ahead of Letitia Scanlon and Ellen Rooney.
And it's not a good final for Susanna. She just missed another one.
Oh.
And Galvez.
She nails that one.
So.
At the moment, it's Basuk and Makela-Nummela who are there or thereabouts.
And then Cox looks like she could be in the second if people hit what they're supposed to.
Cogdell won't be in the running. She had a disappointing semi-final. Here's a chance, though, for the Russian to book a place in the gold medal match.
Yes.
And that she has done.
And both have the quarter spots.
Which is almost as important, isn't it, at the moment as
at
we head
moment,
towards Rio.
Yes. Yes, it is, actually.
Now a shot for Galvez, and this would put her into the bronze medal match.
And
she nails
in.
It as well.
All right.
Well, no shoot-off, and a difficult semi-final for these shooters, and for some athletes in particular, it didn't go well. Cogdell has to bow out as well.
Yes, I think for
also taking part in today's gold medal match, representing
and for Tatiana,
the Russian Federation,
this is very exciting.
Tatiana Basuk.
And
going into the bronze medal match, representing Australia, Emma Cox.
There's confirmation.
And also
by
going
the way.
To the bronze medal match today, representing
Makela-Nummela,
Fatima
and
Galvez.
Russia's Tatiana Basuk, who will contest the gold medal match. Emma Cox,
representing Slovakia,
Fatima
Susanna Rahak Stefanchikova.
Australia against Spain.
And our confirmed sixth position today, representing the United States of America, Corey Cogdell.
Well, another time, nervous time now
we
as people prepare for
the bronze medal,
medal matches.
Just a few moments
again,
time.
If you're a coach, there's not much you can do, is there?
No, you try to keep the person calm, you know, when I'm coaching. You just try to have them make sure everything's ready, that they have everything they need, and that they are you're just taking it easy.
Well, Cox against Galvez, that is the first of our medal matches for the bronze medal. The 22-year-old up against a hugely experienced Galvez from
and not that much older, but 28 years old. But she's far more experienced.
Another 4 years. Yeah, she is, isn't she? She
just
came
amazing.
very close to a medal in the Olympics in London, fifth
yes.
place there. Of course, she has medals in the World Championships, gold, silver there, and
she had gold when she was a junior in the World Championships.
Yeah.
And last year in Granada, she won the silver medal at the World Championships. That was good.
Cox, like you say, a little bit of a, not an unknown quantity,
so
but somebody who's still trying to make their
bronze
mark.
Medal match,
of
representing
course,
Australia, Emma Cox.
Shooting.
Oh,
there
yes.
she is, Emma Cox, who looks delighted
and also
and
taking
thrilled to be in with a chance,
match,
a sniff of a medal.
Representing Spain,
oh, exactly.
Fatima Galvez.
Well, she's been there, done it before.
We shall now begin with today's bronze medal match. Thank you.
She got bronze in Almaty last year, Tuscon in 2012. She'd prefer to be in the gold medal shoot-off, of course, that's for sure.
Of course, both of them would.
But you know, I think this would certainly please Emma Cox in particular. it's whatever happens.
Beautiful picture of the range. Gives a really good idea that you have to go up to the restaurant up top, go up the hill.
Yep.
Oh, there's Miss Emma.
Well, we're ready to go. And Emma Cox will get us underway in this bronze medal match. Still 15 targets, like the semi-final. Shoot off at the end if they're still tied.
And the shots here on 2, 3, and 4, they've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 different 45 degree angles. So they're pretty tough, pretty sharp.
Have to be on their metal.
Get the medal.
Yeah, absolutely. Some disciplines you can in your mind work out what's gone and what's coming. Much more difficult in trap.
Yes.
And these two going toe-to-toe at the moment. The Australian against the Spanish athlete. Cox against Galvez.
Ready.
12 seconds once they are ready to go before they call for the target. And that's the first miss from Cox. Still a long way to go.
You can see that Fatima has a lighter shade lens.
So, ladies and gentlemen, after those first three targets, as you can see, it's Fatima Galvez who currently leads with a total of 3. Perfect round there for her. And Cox currently only 1 target behind with a total of 2. 12 targets remain.
It's funny, I was talking to Jeff Hilgren, who was commentating, and afterwards he was putting his sunglasses away, and I said to him, does it make a big difference? Because I know, obviously, it can do in dark conditions, make the clays look a little bit easier to see. But he said, no, in the end, you just got to shoot the things.
Yeah, some glasses help. You wear them so they will give you a better picture, better color. There are some vision experts in the United States and Canada who spend a great deal of time to figure out the color of lens that works best for you and what condition. And it can make a difference to seeing a target or not.
Certainly can, across all sorts of sports.
Yes, very
cricket,
much so.
American in baseball.
Yes.
Similar sort of thing. Well, a miss from Galvez. We're back on level pegging.
A nice shot. That was at sharp 40 degree left.
And of course, so much more pressure. One of just 2 in the spotlight. And of course, once you've shot, you are standing behind your competitor again. Just got to keep yourself focused.
Yeah, and I think both women are doing a very good job with that.
Well, a long way to go before we start talking about a shoot-off, but they are matching each other. That's a miss, though.
Yeah, that sharp 45-degree angle to the left.
Emma Cox with a perfect round there. That means she's in the lead now with a total of 5 targets. 1 target behind is Fatima Galvez at this early stage. 9 targets remain.
Australia has such top women shooters. I mean, they have top men shooters too, but right now they're really tough.
And more coming through, as we can see.
Yes.
That's a miss, though. And that might well put these two back on level pegging again. He's a bit nippy-tuck, this one. No, that's a miss.
Another sharp.
Of course, these athletes, they know they're going to get the angles, but they're not sure about the elevation. And that's the one thing that can certainly put you off. And Galvez, after a great start, is really struggling here. The one who qualified top, of course, Cox, came, I think it was through the shoot-off.
Yes.
And, We know that sometimes you have to do that to get to the top. Alphatas, of course, 3 shooters in his gold medal triumph earlier in the week.
I did stats last couple of years, looking at people, and people that came up from the 6th position tended to do better than those who started in 1st position when it came into this final format.
I suppose, in a way, you think, I've got nothing, absolutely nothing to lose, have I?
Oh, dear. So she had a shell malfunction?
The referee is just having a little look there. A little conversation amongst the officials.
Yes.
I'm not sure whether there was a problem with the target there.
Oh, she didn't she didn't pull the trigger? Is that so? That's why they're saying it's a loss?
Well, we'll have to try and get confirmation of that.
Yes, they gave her a loss.
Yeah, it's a loss.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's
a real
really, shame.
Yeah, it is.
There's still conversations going on over there about what actually happened, and we can't from where we are here the conversation that is going on. But
well, she went to pull the trigger and she didn't pull the trigger.
Yeah. It happens from time to time, but very
it
unusual
does.
At this level of competition. Anyway, we're underway again.
Emma collected herself. That was good for her.
Yeah, and she knows she has an opportunity here to pull ahead. From Galvez. We'll just have to put that behind her and keep going.
She did well there.
So as it stands at the moment, Emma Cox currently with 7 and Galvez currently with 5. 2 targets separate the two athletes at this stage. 6 targets remain.
Wow, it's a tough one to make up.
2 behind.
Yeah.
With only 6 to shoot.
That's tough.
All things can happen, you never know.
Whoops.
And there you go.
Get my mouse shut.
Commentator's curse. Emma Cox misses one, but she can afford to do that and still almost stumble over the line.
Yeah.
Nice from Galvez, certainly pulled the trigger that time.
Yeah, and very smooth.
Ready?
Cox is left-handed, and we don't have a lot of left-handed shooters in the game.
Went away to the left. She nailed that one nicely.
Yes, very.
Now the thing she has to do is not think about the fact that she's ahead. Just worry about shooting the targets. It's easier said than done, of course. That's an interesting grouping of reds for Galvez.
Mm-hmm.
The question is, can she just keep shooting now? Cox, though, with this last shot, this fourth
nice
pass.
Shot.
And she is looking good, isn't she?
Yeah, she's showing a lot of, what's the word?
Calmness, isn't it?
Yes,
it
really it's just
is.
Lovely.
And another miss from Galvez.
So after 12 targets, as you
composure.
See, Emma Cox
she's
is
very
the
composed
still in the lead with a total of 9. And Galvez
with Galvez
of
having the gun problem. And then missing, Emma's just really keeping composed.
Bronze medals match.
Some athletes like to have those blinders on, but not everyone.
And no.
For some athletes, it's more of a distraction than anything.
Yeah, I don't like having them on because I'd like to be able to see.
Oh, and a miss.
I think that's probably a bit of nerves.
Yeah. Just turned away, took a deep breath there. Of course, these athletes will practice this all the time, and yet, look at this. This is a really poor effort. From Fatima Galvez, she'll be so disappointed.
It's not a poor effort, it's a hard effort. Yeah. I mean, she's had troubles. But the fact of the matter is, she's there and we're not.
Absolutely. But by her high standards, 6 targets missed. Oh, and another one missed by Cox.
Yeah, now that's nerves.
That is nerves. Galvez, though, will need to nail both of these to have any chance of
she got that.
Taking it to a shoot-off. So then, big moment here for Emma Cox of Australia, the 22-year-old looking for her first medal in the World Cup.
That's it. Get composed.
Needs this one just to make absolutely sure.
And she's missed it.
She has missed it. That's 3 out of 3 in that last pass. And I think it is the nerves that are jangling.
Yeah, so and it's really hard.
Galvez needs this one to take it to a shoot-off. And she does.
She did it.
So, goodness me, what drama at the end there.
Very much so.
So, ladies and gentlemen, there will now be another shoot-off. A shoot-off to decide who will take that bronze medal home today and who will go home in fourth place.
So, the pendulum swings again, back perhaps in favour of that woman there, Fatima Galvez, from Baena in Cordoba in Spain. And there's the Australian who just has to pull her thoughts together, calm herself down, put everything out of her mind. It's easier said than done. And it's a sudden death shoot-off. So if one misses and the other one hits, then that is the bronze medal decided.
Yes, it is. So in the sudden death shoot-off, you know that one's going to the on one, I think it goes to the left, and then on two it'll go to the right, and three it'll go to the left, and four it'll go to the right, and five it'll go to the left. So we know that, but...
The rest, we're not so sure about.
Exactly.
Another plane going overhead, heading towards Larnaca Airport. The holiday season just about getting into swing. A lot of people on the beaches, but the shooters are at the range, and we are just about to get underway again.
So the order will be...
Let's see who's stepping up first. Would you prefer in a shoot-off to go first or second?
I like going first.
Yep.
I like going first.
And it is the Australian Emma Cox who has that pleasure.
Ready.
Yep.
And away we go. Oh, and she's missed.
Left. That's sharp
left.
Left.
Yep.
That's a tough one when you get that sharp left.
She's missed the last four, and that's a real shame, but it's not over just yet. Let's see what Fatima Galvez can do here. The Spaniard needs this to take the bronze.
Yeah.
Oh, and she's missed as well.
It's a tough bird. The visibility right now is really tough. When you look out and see that target, you can't see it.
It's lovely light, but it's not necessarily the best light for shooting.
Not a good shooting light, no.
Good for painting, not so good for shooting.
So now this target will go to the right.
Will that help the left-hander?
Yes. I guess not
another
that time,
miss.
But it's that sharp one that's really hard to see. It's low, and it's sharp.
Well, a real murmur behind us in the stands, in the gallery up by the restaurant. So another chance for Fatima Galvez.
Fatima's going to get it. Nope, I was
another
wrong.
Miss.
Okay.
Goodness me.
No one wants it.
It's like a bad dream. Who can stumble over the line first?
Right, now this one will go to the left.
Okay. Well, it's certainly brought its fair share of drama, this finals series already.
Yes, it has.
Cox, who looked like she was strolling to the bronze, hasn't hit one in five yet.
Oh.
And she's missed another. Oh my
man,
word.
That's too bad.
Well, I'm not sure what's going on out there. The wind has dropped.
But the visibility is very difficult.
Yeah,
you look out there, it's very hard to see that target.
The shadows are lengthening. Oh. It's before 6 o'clock.
There she got it.
Local time. And that's Fatima Galvez eventually taking the bronze medal for Spain.
Representing Spain, Fatima Galvez.
Well, it's a real shame for Emma Cox.
And please, a huge round of applause to your fourth place, representing Australia, Emma Cox.
I think she's... almost in tears.
We shall commence.
You can understand why, but you think she'll be back for more because she looked good, didn't she? And it's just that up at the last hurdle, couldn't nail it, and that's a real shame.
Yeah, you know, she shot a 71 in the competition, and that was in fourth spot. So, tied for fourth, so I mean, that's good shooting.
Let's concentrate, though, on the gold medal match. It's Satu Makela-Nummela. Off in and against Tatiana Barzuk of Russia.
Firstly taking part in today's gold medal match, representing Finland, Satu Makela-Nummela.
44 years of age now, but still going
strong.
And also
taking part in today's gold medal match, representing the Russian Federation, Tatiana Barzuk.
30 years of age.
Yeah, and a youngster by comparison.
Let's
begin. Still very, very experienced,
Thank
of course.
Yes.
Gold in the European Championships, three of those, a couple of silvers in the World Cup, but still looking, Barzuk, for her first gold medal in the World Cup.
Yes.
Let's see whether we cruise or stumble through this final.
Well, the lighting is still not great, so it's going to be interesting to see the colors. Now, Satu is using a pinky lens.
Hey.
It seems to look good. And Tatiana is wearing a clear, almost a yellowy clear.
Huh?
So I think that's interesting. Both are different shades than what the other two. Now it's interesting, both women were in that shoot-off, so they had tied for 71. So they weren't the top three scorers.
They're used to their shoot-offs.
Hey.
Yep.
And this is a good start from both women as well.
Yeah. and they're going at a good pace.
It's always a sign of confidence, isn't it, when you're happy to get up there and take the shot. And
exactly.
The quicker
Let's
you
get this over with.
The quicker you shoot, the better you shoot, a lot of people say.
Within reason.
Ready.
As long as you're ready.
As long as you're happy in your preparation and you're
yep.
going through your procedure, so to speak.
Yes.
Well, a perfect first pass for Satu Makela-Nummela. Yeah.
And Satu likes to shoot fast. I've shot with her for a long, long time. She likes to shoot fast.
So after those first three targets,
well, perfect round for three and three for both those athletes.
Both tied at the moment at this early stage with a total Tatiana of three targets. Barsuk. 12 targets remain.
From the Lipetchik Metallurge Club, I'm sure I've probably not said that right. Been competing for 15 years now. Hey. Yuri Kashuba, the national
coach. Sharp one to the left. That's
you
so hard
like
to
that
see.
One. You don't like that one at all, do you?
No, and they don't either.
No, absolutely.
They're tough to see.
Yep.
The visibility is really hard on that tough angle.
There is green, of course, on the bank beyond, but there is
but
a scrub as well, which helps.
But
them.
It doesn't get in, those sharp angles, lefts aren't getting up into that green bank, they're getting into the scrub.
Depends about the elevation as well, doesn't it?
Yeah, there, that was good.
Well, it's certainly symmetrical, their shooting. They miss at the same time, they hit at the same time.
Ready.
Hey!
Good shot.
Yeah. Nice personal fast. Coach, national coach, Matti Nummela, watching. We'll be pleased with that.
Oh. Yeah, he's not here. Her husband.
So after six targets, both athletes dropping one target each in that last round, which means they're still tied with a total of five targets each. Nine targets remain.
Ready.
Bree's just getting up. Our
yep.
Big umbrella that is keeping us in the shade.
Hey.
Just running around a little bit concerned
See,
about that.
The same. So now
yep.
She won't have that again.
Oh.
Straight away.
Straight down the middle. A lot easier, as you say. And it is Barsuk who has
well,
the advantage at
see.
The moment.
Hey.
Now she hit that one. That was good. See, that was higher and it was in the green.
Yeah, the elevation's also, I suppose, is also a factor. Yeah. Sometimes if they stay low, they are tricky, aren't they?
Oh, really hard.
Especially if you're thinking it is going to rise on you and it doesn't.
Yeah. So, Satu shoots with both eyes open, but she has a patch over her left eye so that she doesn't see. And Tatiana shoots with both eyes open. Fatima only shot with one eye, though. So it's always interesting to watch who shoots with both eyes.
It's a little bit different.
Barsuk,
yeah.
It's gone into the lead with a total
very
of
tight
eight,
still,
and only
but
one
the Russian
separates Barsuk
just has
Mella
the advantage in this gold medal match.
One target.
Oh,
six targets
separates?
Remain today.
Yeah. Oh, no, the Egyptians. That's the Egyptian team.
Well, we have athletes from every corner of the world here.
Hey.
Finland against Russia in this gold medal match.
And they both get the Olympic quota spot, so they're excited.
Whatever happens, that's in the bag, so
yes.
That is a good thing.
That's excellent.
Start booking your tickets for Rio.
Yeah. Now, it's interesting to see how the different countries have different ways that they select their team.
I know the Americans is a point system, isn't
yes.
it?
Which, yes.
Even if you get the quota, you don't necessarily get to go.
Yeah.
Huh?
Some have tryouts. You know, different countries have different ways of doing it. Some countries, if you win it, you get it.
But the ISSF rule is it goes to the country. And the country do what they want with it.
Exactly.
So that's when the fun and games begin.
Yes.
Just one behind then. Makela Nummela.
She's back
she's
on.
She's back on it, like you say, and
yeah.
putting the pressure on Barsuk to make sure that she can keep her advantage. She is.
Nice.
Breeze just
so after 12
blowing
targets,
up a little bit here as well.
Guys have gone quick.
This is a lot quicker
it is.
Speed than the bronze medal match,
yes,
isn't it?
One target quite a bit faster.
The total of 10. We now move into our final three targets of today's gold medal match.
So then, three shots remaining in this gold medal match, unless it goes to a shoot-off, of course.
Hey.
Yes. doing her best to hit them all.
She can just hit and hope.
Yes, exactly.
And that is the miss.
Well,
there we go, 11 apiece.
You know what angle that was, didn't you?
I'm pretty sure that was left.
Sharp.
So then, slightly different mentality from the Finn.
Yeah.
Keep going, you're in with a chance.
Attack.
Balasuk, we'll need to put that last one out of her mind. She's missed again.
Oh dear.
Well,
sometimes, you know, especially if you don't have as much of the experience, you can get a little worried.
You could see visibly how angry she was with herself.
Yeah.
Two misses in a row there, and all of a sudden, this one.
Hey.
To
Satu wanted this very badly.
The gold, and she will do as well.
Yeah. You can tell the speed she shot.
Shoots the last one, the Russian, and it's too little, too late, and a poor last
good
pass.
Good shooting.
Gives the gold medal to Satu Makela-Nummela. And both these athletes, of course, taking an Olympic quota place, which will, in some ways, ease the pain.
Ease the pain, yes. But it's good shooting in both their parts.
So there's the gold medal. Goes to the Finnish athlete. That's, her fourth World Cup gold medal. So it's a place she's been before, and no doubt a place she will be
again. So, ladies
again.
And gentlemen, firstly, let's once again, your bronze medalist, representing Spain, Fatima Galvez.
There's the silver medalist, Tatiana Barsuk. She'll be disappointed, as we said, that she didn't manage to get the gold.
My thanks
to you, Susan,
quota place
for your help
country,
today.
Oh,
representing
pleasure.
The Russian Federation, Tatiana Barsuk.
I think Tatiana's going to be still thrilled with the silver.
And your gold
right. There's
medal
confirmation
medalist,
the bronze goes to Galvez. Silver to Barsuk, and gold
Finland,
to Makela-Nummela of Finland.
The bronze medal, representing Spain, goes to Fatima Galvez. The silver medal representing the Russian Federation goes to Tatiana Barsuk. And the gold medal, representing Finland, goes to Satu Makela-Nummela. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Finland.